Okay guys, what we have here is the Nokia 808, and I'm going to look into the phone side of this compared, not the warning. I've already gone from death about the camera. This is the phone side of it. It does obviously give you two options here, and there will be actually a reason why I want to show you that, because there is a problem with this phone, and that's namely the keyboard. I find the keys really hard to use. Now, let's have to bring up a thing. Now, we've got the key here, and I find when trying to type something, you don't always get the right number. And it's really, really hard to get this, and you always get the wrong thing. It's a bit better when you use it on the sideways, the numbers are a bit bigger than when you're using it this way. So this way is easier to use if you're doing text messages, but it doesn't register it that well. Unlike the iPhone, which its keyboard is really easy to use. I find the iPhone is much better for that purpose. So the keys is quite difficult to use, and there is lag in it, and yeah, truthfully, not much really else really to say about this phone. The keys use were quite well, contacts and everything like that for your phone is quite good, but truthfully the keys is very hard to use. So truthfully, that's the main area that I'm disappointed. Maybe I've got big fingers, I don't know. As a camera, this phone is absolutely brilliant. This is actually why I call this a camera phone, not a phone camera. So, yeah. I'll probably be getting the iPhone 5 when it comes out to use as a phone. This will be used more as a secondary phone, mainly for its video capabilities, which is brilliant. I'm still amazed by the photo quality of this phone device. But as a phone, definitely not the best. It really does show the limitations of Symbian, I'm afraid, the OS. But once Nokia start doing the PureView technology with the Windows operating system, or even Android if they go that, I think they're going to go mainly this Windows. It's definitely one to look forward to. So if your needs is more as a phone than the camera, then this is probably not the best phone for you if you don't really want to use the camera. If the camera's capabilities aren't important to you, you just want to take simple snaps, this is definitely not the product for you. But as a if you want to really be able to take some good quality video and photos, then this is still the best one to go with. This is Ian from Aussie Tech. Catch you later.